So let me explain why what you just heard from Steve Bannon did Raynard Jackson was an absolute joke. The fact of the matter is, the very people Steve Bannon is railing against, it's actually him. He's a globalist. He worked it, of course, as he said, at Goldman Sachs. He went out to Hollywood. He was a Hollywood limousine liberal, if you will, working in Hollywood, making money, becoming rich as well. And so what he's doing is he's going down to Alabama and he's telling all those folks about how these other people are taking stuff from you. Yeah, you're actually one of those people. See, that's the reality. See, let me give y'all some history. So in 1968, when Richard Nixon ran for president of the United States, Richard Nixon wanted to combat the Black Panther Party. So therefore, his idea of black power was black economic power. Mm-hmm. Oh, y'all saw the movie Get On Up, right? Mm-hmm. That's exactly how James Brown went on to endorse Richard Nixon, because Richard Nixon began to talk about economics. Richard Nixon began to understand the way to divide black people was to talk to the black business class to keep them separated from the black underclass. And so he began to tout economics. But let's be mindful of history. When Richard Nixon became president, he used the Southern strategy to actually win in 1968. Of course, now 1969, Arthur Fletcher comes in and he puts in place affirmative action. But let me remind you, it was President Lyndon Baines Johnson who held a conference on the campus of Howard University in 1965 talking about the issue of affirmative action, because he understood the Voting Rights Act of 65, the Civil Rights Act of 64 simply was not enough in order to bring African Americans into the mainstream of America because they had been left out. Now, as you begin to listen to Steve Bannon talk about the need for capital, ask yourself this question: why is it that Donald Trump is cutting the minority supplier offices? Why hasn't he put forth an actual economic agenda that specifically talks about African Americans? Steve Bannon talked about in terms of what needs to happen. Okay, he worked in the White House. Please show me the program in the Department of Treasury where you actually having that. He talked about community banks, how they were not helped at all when it came to the bailout. But I do recall a certain congresswoman from Los Angeles, right. Congresswoman Maxine Waters, who was very much involved in trying to get those very dollars for community banks. I do not recall at the time where Steve Bannon was saying, Maxine, I'm with you. I will help you reclaim your time and reclaim black folks' money. I don't recall any of those things happening. This is what I understand, Raynard. I am 49 years old, but I'm the reason slave owners did not want black people to know how to read. This is what I understand. I understand those who pimp us. I understand those who would try to use us. I understand those who would try to play us. Please show me, other than Steve Bannon coming there to give a speech where it somehow spoke to the interests of African Americans, please show me what the plan actually exists. Please show me the bankers who Steve Bannon brought with him to the meeting yesterday. Please show me the venture capitalists that Steve Bannon also brought to the meeting yesterday. No, Raynard, what you got was a Robert Mercer funded speech by the very guy who Robert Mercer funds at Breitbart, because Robert Mercer funds you. This is the same Robert Mercer who's getting sued by somebody right now who said the decline of America began with the black freedom movement in the 1960s. Do understand, Raynard, I am a grown black man, a grown black man who knows how to read. And all I want to know is this here. The day Steve Bannon brings multiple billions of dollars to the table to invest in black businesses, then I will be impressed. But I am not impressed because he simply showed up at your gathering at a hotel with a bunch of people and gave a speech. I've heard speeches before. I give speeches. I could have gave the same speech myself. But if you want to impress me, like my man said, show me the money.
Yes, sir.
Get up.
Not talk, but show me the money.
Yes, sir.
But then you also show me when Steve Bannon is going to stand with Maxine Waters on these critical issues. Raynard, then.
Get him.
Then.
Get him.
I won't clown you.
Huh, man.
I'm out.
Yes, Days sir. On TV One.
I will never lie to you.
Oh, my God.
Roland Martin.
He doesn't want to talk to us. He wants to ignore us.
Uncensored.
Hell no.
No.
That ain't gonna cut it, boo.
Unapologetic.
No, that is fundamentally false. You are wrong.
Unfiltered.
He wants an America where we all look alike. He ain't talking about black people.
Unrelenting.
You better go work out, because you got a fight on your hands.
News One Now with Roland Martin. Weekdays at 7 a.m. on TV One.